What is up, Dacetacular Nation? Welcome to the episode 120 of the Dace Man Show. Yours truly is back, done spending his time down in the nation's capital moving stupid product lines, because that's just boring and you used to do it for like 14 hours a day. It was so much fun that I just stopped doing it. Well, I got a great show for you tonight. We are on the countdown and the road to New York Comic Con. Tomorrow we will be there live. Not really live. We're going to record everything we do over the weekend and bring it to you next week as well as throughout the week. Weekend, you can catch us on fanboysnotice.com. But joining me this week from the other side of town, Kimmy McTits.
Why am I Kimmy again?
That's what you are on my phone. Deal with it.
Oh, okay.
And Frank!
Okay, yeah. Hi.
And Gibby is downloading a game for our guest that will be here October 28th. And he's probably going to download that. And if he doesn't get in, just play that because he's a dick.
Interviews.
Yeah, we got an interview. We're back on that kick again. So, woo.
Yay, friends.
When you actually read your emails.
Friends. Right, we could have had Obama, but we missed that email.
We did. So we're going to get Donald Trump as soon as possible. Oh, here he is. Flying from the north to the south to migrate to warmer temperatures. Gibby!
Thank you. I know I'm gone.
I'm glad you have a different entrance each week. Phenomenal. So I've been gone for 2 weeks. I'm back here to motivate the crew and get them a little juiced up and try to fill those awkward silences that Gibby likes to bring to the table.
Woo.
You and your damn stammering.
Woo.
I taught a tall pony cat.
Woo.
That is Gibby's motto. Are you still trying to upload that game?
That's cool. I can't
still
hear.
Still bring the awkward silences. It's great. What do you mean you can't hear?
Oh, God damn it.
What?
I'm trying to play the game, man, but the sound controls don't work.
Well, don't play the game during the show. We're podcasting live for the people to hear. The millions upon millions.
I'm doing my research.
You have all weekend to do the research since you were the only dick on this crew that didn't get a Comic-Con pass because you just, quote-unquote, didn't want to.
That's way too much work.
You're the longest tenured and most appearances on this show, and you just didn't want to go. It's cool.
Did you really expect more from me?
A little bit. I was hoping.
You had to log out and then log back in, and it saves your sound settings.
You really expected Gibby to put effort into anything, Dace?
Well, he's taking this game interview by the horns and running with it, mainly because he got a free product key.
That's scary.
I'm going to do elimination, guys. See what's going on.
Don't review the game now. You'll just take away everything we have to do in 2 weeks.
I'm watching Arrow, so yeah.
You guys, I'm
glad you're watching Arrow.
How am I watching Arrow? What do you mean, how am I watching Arrow?
I said, why?
Because
it's The Flash.
Because Arrow, it's the season premiere of Arrow, like, currently happening right now.
Oh,
get a DVR.
You want to pay for it?
No.
Then shut up.
Get a DVR.
Pay for it.
Get a DVR.
Pay
Wait
for
a
it.
Doesn't that go? What's it called?
What?
On
Yeah, but I don't feel like waiting till tomorrow night.
You'll be busy
Get a
tomorrow.
DVR.
Bite me, asshole.
Get a DVR.
Pay for it.
Time for sport.
Talk about sports.
This week's sports brought to you by DVR. Get a DVR.
Get a DVR.
Pay for it.
Wait for it.
She said pay for it.
Same thing.
What is wrong?
He's just creeping up behind her. Surprise.
Hi.
It's not a surprise that it's Gibby. You usually are expecting Gibby to creep.
Yeah. So is it really rape if he does it then?
No.
I mean, you
because
to
I would never be willing. Oh,
well,
you're willing
you
all the
that.
Time. You just don't
yeah.
ever, you know, want to admit to it.
We have audio proof of you saying yes one time.
Also, by the way, Frank, The Flash isn't as funny without your commentary, so I can't watch it.
That's true. Nerd!
And in sports, last night, Major League Baseball had its first wild card game where the Houston Astros beat the Yankees 3-2-0. New York Yankees still have not led in a postseason game since Derek Jeter sprawled in the dirt 3 years ago, screaming in pain from a broken ankle. It's a string of playoff losses that reached 5 straight this Tuesday night to match a franchise record. The team had a streak of 9 games without a win from 1921 to 23, but that stretch included a tie in the 1922 World Series. So the season ended on a 3-0 loss to the Houston Astros in the winner-take-all AL wildcard game. Shouldn't have been a surprise because the Houston Astros are pretty much nurturing a Cy Young Award winner. Tonight in MLB, you can catch the Cubs versus the Pirates.
Cubbers.
Not there yet, guys. But DVR it and watch it after our show. Into NFL Week 4 results. Thursday, October 1st.
I lost. Bad.
I won. 4-0. Thursday, October 1st, the Ravens beat the Steelers 23-20. Heading into Sunday, where the Jets beat the Dolphins 27-14. The New York Giants beat the Bills 24-10. The Panthers beat MRSA 37-23.
Yay.
The Raiders fell to the Bears.
Double.
Oh, God damn it. 20-22. The undefeated Kansas City Chiefs lost to the Bengals 21-36. The Falcons beat the Texans 48-21. The Jaguars fell to the Colts 16-13. The Colts missing Andrew Luck this week. Eagles fell to the team that shall not be named in what was a disappointing fourth quarter, 23-20. The Chargers beat the Browns 30-27. The Broncos beat the Vikings 23-20.
They had
The Packers beat the 49ers 17-3. Rams beat the Cardinals 24-22. Saints beat the Cowboys 26-20, and in a nail biter, the Detroit Lions fell to the Seattle Seahawks, allowing Chris Dace to go 4-0 in his fantasy football league. And that is your
We have been reading the fantasy sports standings.
Why? Why the fuck would they care about what we do?
Because it's us and we're the show, and people need to know.
No,
so you I gotta bring that up right now.
I can do it.
I got it. It's up.
Well, you made it sound like it was going to be such a hassle for you.
It is.
Didn't want to inconvenience you, oh great one.
The current standings for the Dacetacular Nation League, still don't know why it's named that, the team that recently renamed themselves from the Lazio Shit Zippers to the Buffalo Billies are 4-0. That's me, people. That's me. And
Lock.
Nothing matters after that. So moving on. Just kidding. In second
I
is
got
Patty
hit,
and
guys.
The McTitties with 3-1.
I got
and one.
Hit, guys.
Shut up. Third is Dan Top, Brian Bottom. Fourth is the Grundle Commies. You may remember him as Nick Andrew on the show. How he's in fourth with drafting 3 quarterbacks in the draft. The world is baffled.
How is that? I don't understand that. Lucky
it's
bastard.
Because everybody else is looking at projections, and Nick and I are playing on a win. Ben there, right? That is in fifth place, which is our own Gibby. One Man Wolfpack is the man that's banned from this show, Dan Ralph. Parole to Pacas is somehow related
Why
to Gibby.
Why did we ban him from the show now?
He uses bad words. Aki.
Oh, true.
I don't know what that means.
Aki, bad. Aki, put it out.
Aki, Poppy, Aki. That's what I see. Is in eighth. Bill Cosby's Sleepers is in ninth and in last place.
Woo!
1-3 record and only 354.66 points. Hangovers Anonymous.
My total points is what Trisha's put up in a week. Sad.
What? How does that make you feel?
We're pretty butthurt about it.
That's good.
Oh, that was a sound bite that you were looking for for me. Wasn't
oh.
it? Was it? Was it for me?
Yeah,
was
well,
that a
I could have done it.
Did I miss the cue?
You always miss the cue.
Yeah, I was going to say this. When do you ever get the cue correctly?
You had one time where I think you hit it perfectly. Once.
Not well, that's it. When I wasn't actually talking in the show and I was just playing with the soundboard.
Yes.
This is my main man,
John Cena!
That was
Dace,
not a cue
you,
for that.
Wait, Dace, you will appreciate this show much, and I showed it to Frank. My friend was texting his other friend, and he was talking about how his dog doesn't respond to any names or, like, any names anymore of that. And he goes, well, he does respond to one. And then his friend answers, what is that? And he just goes, John Cena, in all caps. And I was nearly pissing my pants laughing.
Got that from the show. Check out the Dace Man show where John Cena follows me. He does. He follows me. It's a real thing.
I don't believe it.
You don't believe it. Go check my followers. John Cena is one of them. And it's because of what I do here on this show.
Is it the actual John Cena, or is
it
a fake one?
It is. It's verified. It is verified. Check it out. He follows me and Jeanette McCurdy. Don't know why. Probably because I speak fondly of them on this show. Just saying.
Don't do that.
Don't you have nasty thoughts about Jeanette McCurdy?
I say nice things to her.
You can have plenty of nasty thoughts. That's perfectly fine.
Well, in other sporting news, besides this pervert lane that's going on over there.
Curling?
Curling is up to date. They have updated the top 15 men and women September 22nd of this year. We have a new number one. Brad Gushu from St. John's.
Gushu, my man.
Is number one. Nicholas Eden from Sweden is number two. Mike McEwen from Winnipeg is number three. Brad Jacobs from Sault Ste. Marie is in fourth. And Kevin Coe from Calgary is in fifth. Heading over to the women in the exciting world of curling news. Rachel Holman from Ottawa is in first. Alina Payet from Switzerland is in second. Eve Marie Hand is from Scotland. Savannah is from Switzerland in fourth.
Go Switzerland!
And Lung from Korea is in fifth.
Is it actually pronounced? No.
I'm voting for Kuzurska.
It's Kim in fifth from Korea. They didn't say north or south, so therefore we can't either appraise them or tell them to fuck off. We don't know which one they're from. And that's sports! Gibby!
Sports, what?
Can I follow
these
people?
Are you still in the game, or are you ready for weird news?
Do they have Twitter accounts?
You're going to make me exit out of my game?
How do you spell Gushu?
I don't know. I'm going to make you exit out of your game. What the heck is this? There's a new soundbite.
Uh-oh! Retard alert! Retard alert, class! Is that Gibby's new theme?
God.
I'm going to use that one a lot.
Is that Gibby's new theme?
Well.
Oh, that is great. I should tell you. What
are those? How do you know they're new clips? Do you have this thing memorized?
It's something I haven't. An Artard alert? I've never seen that on here before. Oh. That kind of just stands out. Especially John Cena, where it's all in caps. It just stands out when you see these type of things. But are you ready for your segment, or are you just still playing that game?
If you want me to do my segment, I could.
I think I'm going.
Give it! Sorry.
What?
kind of brought down the game there, bruh.
Sorry.
Kind of hurt my game, bruh.
Bruh, he was wrong, bruh.
Come on, bruh.
Where he was ending his game. It fit. He was ending his game. It was the game over button, and I thought it fit, and I was just trying
problem,
to help.
We got a problem, bruh?
I was just trying to
help. We got a problem, bruh?
I thought this was America.
Bruh?
Good news is, I almost forgot to activate my Comic-Con pass.
You know what's good news? John Cena!
He's fat!
You're fat, son. You fat.
He is anything but fat. That man is a god. If I could look like John Cena.
Attractive as fuck.
That's okay. You've ruined him.
He's kind of short,
though. News
he's kind of short, isn't he? Like a little midget? A little munchkin?
I think he's about a couple inches shorter than me.
5'2"?
You minimize the screen and it turns off the sound. Interesting.
Yeah. Are you ready? Or are you just going to keep jerking off?
All right. Give it!
Boy, that escalated quickly.
Boy. Wow.
Ellie! Sorry.
What is your major malfunction, numbnut?
I think we found a great soundboard operator.
Yes, we did.
I just wish I could, sort these better.
That's great. You bring so much energy to a segment.
Woo! Get pumped, it's Gibby!
He lets out this big-ass sigh, takes the drink, and goes, yeah.
Thanks for noticing me.
Damn, I need some more hard liquor. Jessica Mendoza became the first woman to work as an analyst during the MLB postseason game on Tuesday night as part part of the ESPN broadcast booth for Houston Astros and the New York Yankees in the AL.
Sorry, keep going. I didn't mean to throw out your vibe. Or just sit there and pant into the mic. That's not creepy. Don't you, Jesus Christ, mate.
Right. Come on.
Are you drinking?
Yeah, I am. I'm drinking. I'm drinking a lot. Tends to happen on Wednesday. I can't figure out why that is.
He sounded so defeated on that. I tend to be drinking a lot.
You should drink a lot more before your segment so you get interesting. Like the second guy.
Alright, anyway. Mendoza, for people who don't know, is 34 and is an Olympic gold medalist in softball and is considered one of the best players ever in the game.
You don't say.
So, Mike Bell, a sports radio jockey in Atlanta, would know better. After all, he has a radio show on 92.9 The Game. He knows how broadcast works. Bell sent out the following tweet during Tuesday's game. Yes, tell us Tits McGee when you're up there hitting the softball. You see a lot of 95-mile-an-hour cutters.
What did you just say? Was that English? All I heard was Tits McGee.
Mike Bell goes, yes, tell Tits McGee when you're up there hitting the softball, you see a lot of 95-mile-an-hour cutters.
Is it the Tits McGee part that's offensive, or is it the cutters part? Are they throwing emos at him?
He must be a loyal listener of this show, if he's calling a woman Tits McGee.
Or is it Tits McGee? Titty, are you out there playing football?
Is that you, Trish?
Yeah.
What?
Oh, fuck you.
Yeah, thanks for paying attention.
I told you.
Mike Bell goes, really? A woman softball slugger as a guest analyst on MLB wildcard game. Once again, ESPN too freaking cute for their own good.
You can't do your job because you're a woman. That's what he's saying.
You guys are telling me there isn't a more qualified baseball player ESPN can use than a softball player? Give me a break.
I can do it. I'm qualified. I'm charismatic. Whoa,
and you're a softball player.
And he hit it with that stick thing. Look at it go. Yankees lose. The country's happy.
Woohoo.
Yay.
Woo for sexism. I mean, no.
Woo. Screw your equal rights.
Yeah.
I agree.
You want to go call a baseball game, go play baseball, not softball.
Why did half my stuff? Why isn't all my stuff? Oh my god! I wonder if it's because I'm in this game. Maybe. All right. Ready for my next story, guys? Ready for my next story?
Go on.
When you
like
Gap Islands, I gotta jump in. Kind of the host.
All right. Why is my computer frozen?
One fine day, there was a wolf in a pear.
Sucks to be you, nerd.
Does suck to be me.
So, do you need me to stall? What's going on?
Yeah, because I can't. All my things are frozen.
In weird news, NASA has discovered that Dan Ralph is ugly. From a
surprise, motherfucker!
I'm surprised too. From a satellite in space, they caught a lunar eclipse of his face and realized that the craters that are on it were not attractive. And often his attitude and personality was not favorable with women. NASA says they would wish to eliminate this threat on Earth, but realize that they can't legally kill a man. So, Dan Rapp, if you're listening, kill yourself and do NASA and the world a favor. Back to you, Gibby!
All right.
We need to talk about bullying on this show.
If you get another gap, I'm going to bully other people. So, make sure those pages load.
So there was a controversial poster for a nightclub.
With a dick?
Swag.
It's dicks. Anytime it's controversial, it's got a dick.
The event was Shag a Ginger Night.
Okay, it had a dick and a ginger.
A Donghela nightclub has been canceled after it sparked outrage with parents after a local protest.
Was this like a 17
Somebody please think of the children!
You are course. Spot on with the soundboard tonight.
There's still a delay, though. Like, I click it, and then it's like 2 seconds before it finally goes.
That's okay. He drags out his sentences so fucking long, it makes sense.
So, apparently, gingers enter for free, guys. Any gingers, you get in for free. The night has now been changed to Kiss Me, I'm Ginger.
I like Shag Me, I'm a Ginger.
With organizing stating it was tongue-in-cheek and not to be taken literally. Organizers of the event at Pulse Nightclub in Letterkenny took to social media to promote the original Shag a Ginger event and offered free condoms as well as free entry for gingers before 12 a.m.
Let's get up on that red carpet.
But parents reacted in disgust as the planned event, Glenfinn Parish priest contacted the club to tell them what he thought. He said, I got a phone call from a mother who said she was fuming and she went on to tell me about the page that was on Facebook.
So wait. This is a like nightclub, right? Adult theme, like bar, have to be 21 or older to participate? That is this event? Or is it like Chuck E. Cheese? Did I miss something?
I have no idea. It doesn't say how old they are. It just says a nightclub.
Well, why the fuck are parents outraged if it's a nightclub? That's my point.
There are nightclubs that let people in that are 17 and 18.
I was going to say, yeah.
Oh, okay.
But that makes sense that they get outraged there. But at the same time, they're 18, they're an adult, they can do what they want.
Yeah,
what do you think goes on with these clubs anyway?
It says, the promotion of such events on student nights are commonplace throughout the county and have occurred in the past throughout without knowingly causing offense.
Have you seen the way they dance at homecoming?
No, I haven't.
You're not allowed to grind. Keep it apart.
Half these kids have fucking kids already. So what are you complaining about?
Don't go to the dance club
where you can't legally have sex because a bouncer will separate you. Go hang out in the woods where you're going to make a mistake. With
Gibby.
Little Jimmy.
Oh.
Or little Gibby.
Why not?
Somehow Gibby is like 0-10. He's gone 10 years with a girlfriend, doesn't have a kid. I'm thinking he's sterile or his little goose babies don't know how to fly.
He probably honestly doesn't even make it in the vagina as much as he thinks he does, so the sperm just kind of goes other places.
Hey,
really?
Welcome back. Sex expert.
Wow. She just
Talk
said
about
that.
Sally,
huh?
Jesse, Raphael.
Coming from somebody, huh?
It ain't because you're a lesbian.
Thanks.
You're welcome. What's your next
All right,
story?
Guys.
More teens trying to bang it in a strip club? Maybe there's some...
Whiskey, are we?
I am. And maybe there's some, like, bubbles and foam. Foam's a good correction. You don't know where you're sticking it. There's
Can't you get herpes from that foam? Isn't that... Then they carry diseases?
I think
are
so.
Are you ready?
That is syphilis. Go ahead.
All right, 27-year-old man from Howell, New Jersey.
Oh, my God,
Howell.
Oh, sorry, I picked up on one.
Howell, New Jersey.
Oh, my God, I'm from New Jersey!
Who the hell cares? Wanted to test drive an all-wheel drive performance of the car he had just purchased.
The police said,
he drove off the paved road and into an open field where he could do donuts.
I just did that!
The trouble is that while it may have been his new car, it was not his field. And once the car got hopelessly stuck in the mud, the only thing he tested was the patience of police officers and a local towing company who were called to the scene. Police said the man will be summoned to appear in court on charges of trespassing by motor vehicle. I have no idea what word that is. Destruction of property in excess of $250, according to the Post. What?
I don't know. He done fucked up.
Apparently, damages to the property were $2,000.
It wasn't me.
Fucking bullshit!
Yeah, who fuck needs corn? It's not corn season. Did you a favor? Fucking mulched your lawn.
You never know.
Okay. Turn that topsoil. I made it plantable. You're welcome.
All right, guys. We're going to go.
My fault. You got to plant in circles now.
We're going to go to Southern California now, guys.
More you know.
Southern California man called 911 early this morning to complain that his girlfriend would not have sex with him.
Right on, brother!
Boo!
We support you!
When a cop responded to his Spartanburg residence, Patrick Duguette, 53, stated he called 911 because his girlfriend, Fane Woodruff, would not give him any ass.
It's got us, we're pretty butthurt about it.
Woodruff told police that Duggett had been drinking all day and I don't know where he was at. She added that Duggett got into the bed and wanted to have sex, but she had her grandchildren with her.
Whoa, what?
So Woodruff noted Duggett got up and then dialed 911. Duggett, who was outside the resident drinking an alcoholic beverage when the police arrived, was arrested for public intoxication and booked into the county jail, where he remains locked up this afternoon, guys.
Womp womp.
Womp womp.
Wait, what was he arrested for, exactly?
Public intoxication.
But he was on his property.
I don't know. Who the hell knows nowadays?
Can you really get in trouble for being on your property drunk?
If
outside?
Yeah.
Pee into the street?
Well, in Jersey you can. No, I don't know about...
Seriously, if I was sitting out on the front porch and a cop decided to roll by and be like, hey, you've been drinking?
Well, if you have an open container outside, yes.
Really?
Seriously?
In Jersey you can, yeah.
We do that all the time.
But,
Fucking bullshit!
And by, I mean, we do that all the time. Don't drive by here.
Somebody would have to complain, though. I mean, the cops aren't obviously going to do it unless somebody complains.
Mm-hmm. Still, that's
yeah, because otherwise, I'll hit him with a beer can. Hashtag drug lives matter! Too soon? Too soon. Too soon, I get it. I'm sorry.
Hashtag. I can tweet that.
Don't. You realize when you tweet these things, it says Dace.
No, it says Dace Man. Show. Totally unaffiliated with your name, completely.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
This is a whole show that you've blatantly said that you run and tweet everything from.
Exactly, my friend. Exactly. Any other questions?
Hands up, don't shoot.
That's right. Austintown Township police were called to a home Friday night by a man who complained he was too high after smoking marijuana. According to police report, authorities were called to the 100 block of Winminster Ave at about 5:20 p.m. Friday by a 22-year-old male who had smoked the drug. Officers who responded to the home could hear the man groaning from a room. The officers found the man lying on the floor in the fetal position and was surrounded by a plethora of Doritos, Pepper Ridge Farm Goldfish, and Chips Ahoy cookies.
Danger zone!
The report said. The man also told police he couldn't feel his hands. A glass plate with marijuana residue, two packs of rolling papers, two roaches, and a glass jar of marijuana was recovered from the man's car after he gave the keys to the police. The man denied medical treatment at home Friday night. Austintown police have not charged the man in the incident as of late Monday morning.
Is this?
See what happens, guys? You can smoke too much. You can't smoke too much.
Oh, never mind.
What are you doing?
Awkward silence!
I'm checking some of these sound clips that I haven't noticed before.
Alright.
Like, why are... Some of these are so long. Like, what could be so long about Death Time a Cow?
It was a whole...
That's a pig. That's a pig. Still a pig. Okay, that's enough of that. What's this one?
You part? Are you clicking? Are we about to fight? All right.
Yeah, we
all
are.
Right.
Let's go, Jason. Okay. Right now. Right
Come
now.
On,
the
Let's go,
Right
bro.
Now, bro.
What
I'm gonna kill
do,
you.
Bro?
You two.
Come
man.
On, bro.
You don't understand.
Let's go.
You're gonna die. You're gonna
Fuck
die.
You
You've
on,
got no
bro.
Shot. No
Let's
shot.
Go, bro.
No
bro.
Shot.
Bro.
Look at those muscles. They're not existent.
And your winner, Gibby.
What?
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, he totally won. He's quicker. He got body shots.
Didn't hear him. You didn't even hear him. Fucking smashed his head with a brick, bruh.
I heard squawkity squawk squawk squawkity squawk.
Exactly. All you need, man. All you need.
See,
pack
no,
your
no,
eyeball
no.
out.
I got a tag team partner.
John Cena!
Don't worry, I have the Man of Steel as my partner.
Ginkleberg.
Ginkleberg. Alright, guys. Fashion choices of one super dumb criminal may have been his kryptonite. According to Upper Darby Police, who said they captured a burglary suspect this week thanks to the man's penance for wearing a Superman t-shirt.
Sorry, I was late on that one.
Uh-oh, retard alert! Retard alert, class!
Kyrie Hennigan, 18, of West Philadelphia, was charged...
Born and raised on the playground is where he spent most of his days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys, they were up to no good, started making trouble in the neighborhood. He got one little fight and his mom got scared. What's your auntie and uncle in Bel Air?
Go on.
I just told you the whole story. There's no more to that story. He moved to Bel Air. End.
End.
Was charged with 2 counts of burglary and related offenses for break-ins that occurred this weekend last at Upper Darby Police Superintendent Michael Clitwood. The first...
You get it? It's so funny.
I don't get it.
Burglary
so
took place about 12:30 p.m. September 24th when Hennigan...
I don't get it.
Who was wearing a Superman t-shirt and red Chuck Taylor sneakers broke into a house on Powell Lane near Chestnut Street and stole an iPhone, a wallet, and a bank card.
Check them kicks, though.
Instead of flying away from the scene, this un-Superman used his BMX bike to make his getaway.
Stoner.
Then around 11 a.m. Tuesday... He burglarized a house on Glen Cove Road near Sansom Street, not far from the first location. Hennigan was wearing his signature Superman t-shirt.
Signature? How can it be signature?
And red Chuck Taylors when the owner of the house walked in while he was committing the burglary.
Maybe he's a villain.
He said to the guy,
looking for a guy in red Chuck Taylors.
Your wife let me in.
Did you see the guy around the park wearing the I'm training to be Batman t-shirt?
Dude.
I wanted to ask him how his bankroll's going, because you kind of have to be a billionaire.
There's a guy that talked to somebody's wife and let him in. Have you seen him? Also, show me the wife, because she's pretty fucking stupid. Have you seen Superman in red Chuck Taylors?
Hennigan was able to leave the house with a laptop computer on his slower than a speeding bullet BMX bike.
Can you also find me the author
but
of this article?
But he soon learned that he was not dealing with some Smallville police department. Upper Darby cops who received all determined Hennigan was heading into Philadelphia and officers located him thanks to his Superman t-shirt and sneakers while he was attempting to sell the stolen laptop from his bicycle.
Help from me, Batman.
To some men in a car at 62nd Street in Walnut in West Philadelphia.
Born and raised on the playground where was man
when taken in for questioning, Hennigan was far from steely with investigators and admitted to committing all the burglaries.
Can you tell me who penned this article?
Your mom, then.
Tired of its nerd references. Sucks to be you, nerd. He just keeps talking about Smallville. Well, there's actually crime. If anything,
all right, guys.
Philadelphia's Gotham. And I'm the watchful protector.
A man has opened his arm and his car to a foul walking down the street.
When you say foul, do you mean the Penguin? Do you need the Batman to solve this?
Befriending the stray farm animal.
Was it Gibby?
And taking him under his wing.
Are you a villain, Gibby?
Gibby, did you get lost?
Instagram user Kenzie the Fa Nisa uploaded several video clips of his account showcasing his buddy.
This is Batman, Kenzie. Where's your buddy? I need to Batman him.
Who she named CC? Or CECE, whatever the hell that means.
Anybody know where CC is?
Found CC last night. Out my drunk mind in the middle of the road. I stopped traffic and everything to get CC for real.
You
catch an
CC.
Introduction picture which featured the bird snacking on a cup holder in the back seat. The man said he was drunk when he crossed paths with CC, and the rare duo have been thugging ever since, guys. He never allowed.
Retard alert! Retard alert, class!
He even allowed the bird to sleep on his couch for the night.
Did he bother to ask why he was crossing the road?
No. No, he didn't. What
doesn't
a bad person.
Doesn't he get the hard hitting? What?
Where's the pizza?
In one video, the man places the chicken in his arms with rap music on full blast while the bird appeared to be totally confused about its whereabouts. Another video shows a man who frequently expressed his love for food with drooly worthy plate shots attempted to feed CC a chicken wing.
Oh my god.
Yes.
That is just mean. That is mean and cruel.
I'd
probably do the same thing, but mean and cruel.
While Petey likely won't be too pleased, the Instagram star followed chuckled at strange new relationship. Made my morning, one commenter wrote. Man, this is so funny, another one chimed in.
LOL, said the New York Times.
Yeah, baby.
I waffled my dick off.
My last story, guys. My last one.
What?
It is about Batman.
Cedar Rapids police encountered a walking...
I know that place. I know that place. I've been there. Go on.
Okay. Congratulations. Do you want a cookie?
Yeah, I want a cookie.
$0 to give.
Cedar Rapids police encountered a walking meth lab.
Yep. Woo! Go Iowa!
Public safety spokesman Greg Buell said officers responded to the area of 9th Avenue and A Street at 11:50 p.m. for a report of a suspicious suspect. Bellows said police located 46-year-old Gianno Ruiz and a woman walking in the area and stopping to speak with them. When the officer spoke to Ruiz, they detected a chemical odor on him. Police searched Ruiz and found 16.5 grams of marijuana on him. As he was being handcuffed and placed under arrest, police found 20 ounces pop bottle tucked into his waistband of Ruiz's pants, obstructed by his sweatshirt. Bruce said there was a cloudy substance in the pop bottle containing a lithium battery strips. The container is what known in the law enforcement as a one-pot style meth lab.
It's funny watching you talk about, or listening to you talk about drugs. You are clearly a guy that has no idea what's going on.
No, I don't. Ruiz was taken into custody and faces charges of manufacturing a controlled substance, possession of a controlled substance, and two counts of possession of meth precursors. That's all I got, guys.
I don't know. You were invigorating.
He's that close to his penis. I'm just saying.
My loins yearn for you after the way you talk. You've got like a Morgan Freeman voice.
I know. But it's all good. It's all good.
And I
know you want me. Don't worry. I know you want me.
A little bit. I'm not going to let you know who else wants you.
You just want to jump on it. I understand.
John Cena!
Oh, yeah. John Cena wants me.
So I guess that means it's time for a segment where... Gay! I won't be put to sleep. Time for Frank's Corner!
Interpretation is brought to you by Taste and Good Form.
Tell me something, my friend. You ever dance with the devil in the pale moonlight? Nobody can save this corner.
You suck.
Hey.
Sorry.
I think he was going to respond with, I can't believe they let me start my segment without interrupting me. And then you responded with, you suck.
See, every time that I expect you guys to just blast my segment is when you don't. But whenever I'm ready to...
I'm sorry.
So I'm thinking I should go back to my game. What do you guys think?
Well, yeah, Dace is watching Arrow because she brings absolutely nothing to the table.
Yeah, she never...
I thought about hanging up on her.
Table.
Glad you got a press pass from the Dace Man show. You contributor.
I'm still listening, asshole.
You, I don't
fucking
moocher.
Yeah. Wow. Gotta go watch your Arrow and not pay attention to the show that you're supposedly part of.
Buy a DVR!
Exactly.
The whole point is to participate in the podcast, not listen to it.
Yeah,
anybody can listen to it.
I chime in on the commercial.
Can you get me another beer?
No, you didn't. When was the last time you chimed in? And get me another beer.
Well, the last commercial,
guys,
I chimed in on because I realized Guitar Hero Live actually looks really good.
Yes, so is your... Never mind.
That was a big compliment. Yeah, that would have been wrong.
I don't want to do that.
Down on the corner, it's just Frank and me. Gibby went to get a beer, and Trish brings nothing but the TV.
Good.
Okay, well then, what I have is things to make you hate your life more, like usual. It's been a while since I've done this.
Number one.
No, it's not right, you're wrong, you're all idiots. Leave me alone. God damn it.
Okay.
This is what you talk to. Did you have an intervention, and this is how you responded?
I have no idea what happened. I went and got a beer, so I thought I would just interrupt.
Did you have like a...
Shut up, Trish. No one cares. Jeez.
Scary, Gibby.
I hear music. Your show's back on. Go on mute.
Yeah, really. Yeah, go back on mute, please. Thank you. Jeez.
No, it just went back to commercial. You're wrong.
You leave us alone, all right? We don't need to know anything.
Hey your post about our interview that we have in a couple weeks.
Yeah.
It's getting some attention. It just sent me a notification.
Right.
Did you see that?
No. It
sent a notification saying it's doing like 95% better than your other post, which isn't much, but it has like...
It's usually not.
What?
Who is that? What is this madness that's happening in the background?
Doesn't
know how to use the mute button. Buy a DVR!
Dude, pay for it!
I'm not paying for it.
Then stop telling me to buy a DVR.
Stop sucking.
Please stop sucking. Is that why her knees suck? Her knees are so bad?
I think so.
My knees are fine. My back is bad, you dumbass.
Ooh.
All the bending over to touch toes.
Ooh.
Ah, skeet, motherfucker.
Ooh.
Ah, skeet, goddamn.
Ooh.
So you had a list?
Ooh.
Ooh. Oh, my. Oh, my.
Disney!
Yeah.
No, but for real, though, did you guys see Guitar Hero Live?
God damn it.
I reserved it.
Hell yeah, Guitar Hero Party! It. Woo! Now,
but I don't have the system to play it on, so...
Shut the fuck up. It's
you
time for 25 standing food that you should never eat.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly.
So listen up, Chubbs.
You still haven't gotten your PlayStation 4?
Should be here by the time I get back from Comic-Con. But Frank, you have a list?
Yeah. Shit you should stop eating.
Frank, your list sucks!
Number one, Smoothie
don't
King.
Don't tell me what to do!
Exactly.
Buy a DVR!
We already have one. Go buy yourself a Smoothie King's Hulk Strawberry Smoothie.
Really? Kinder drink those.
Yeah, fruit and yogurt can't be bad, right? Wrong.
No, it can't. Don't ruin it for me!
Smoothies are often made with ice cream or milk, which can be crammed with sugar. At least this treat gives you a heads up. It's listed on the menu for people looking to gain weight. But the calories are excessive. More than two Big Macs put together. And that's just the small. If you get a 20-ounce smoothie, that is 1,000 and 44 calories, 35 grams of fat with 120 grams of sugar.
Damn, you're going to die, son. You're going to die.
So what you should get instead is the low-carb strawberry smoothie that has 268 calories, 9 grams of fat, and only 3 grams of sugar.
Is pierogies on this list?
I didn't hear what you said.
I don't know. You'll find out as I go through the fucking list.
I hope not, because we both made some pretty good ones.
Can you write down the good things they tell you to eat? Because I'm starting a diet on Monday, because I want to look amazing.
Low-carb strawberry smoothie.
Yeah, I never go to
a
smoothie.
To look amazing because he's a faggot.
Wait, what are you trying to look amazing for? You have no one to impress.
Life? Me?
No, he's got to try and impress me. Yo, seriously.
Gibby, impressing you is having a hole for you to fuck.
Whoa. Oh, you got a hole for me to fuck? Okay,
thank you.
Bend over, please. Thank you.
Allie,
bend over to the front. Touch your toes.
The noise you'll be making when Gibby gets in you. Or Gibby might be making that noise when he gets in you. Who knows?
Oh, baby. That's what I like to hear.
Well, we got through item number one.
I could be reading 15 things that happen after a breast reduction.
That's right, Trish.
Men don't care anymore.
I need a breast reduction. It's bad.
Yeah. Okay, why is this the time you finally decide to chime the fuck in?
Yeah, really.
I have
out of here.
Arrow's almost over.
Go back to your goddamn show.
Usually talked about, it's about me, so...
anyway.
My bad.
Starbucks double chocolatey chip frappuccino blended cream with whipped cream.
That's the only thing I drank from there. Seriously. That is the only thing I drank from there.
You don't... When have you ever gone to Starbucks?
That specific frappuccino?
New York Comic Con last year.
Oh, yeah.
And did you get a Starbucks double chocolatey chip frappuccino blended with cream?
No, he did. I actually remember buying him one.
That's the only thing that was the drink there. Thank you for ruining my weekend, Frank.
You're welcome. That's what this segment for.
What am I supposed to drink all weekend now? My water? Who drinks water? Healthy people? Not... Fucking freaks.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well, if you let... Would you let me finish? Can I finish?
I'm melting down.
This afternoon pick-me-up delivers nearly one-third of the maximum fat you should consume in one day. And over half a day's saturated fat. If you get a 16-ounce grande, that's 510 calories, 19 grams of fat, 11 grams of saturated fat, 59 grams of sugar, and 300 milligrams of sodium. I don't know why they threw the sodium in there, but they did. Your best bet is a regular cup of Joe. Without all the bells and whistles.
It tastes like dirt.
So,
coffee,
I don't think they understand the point of that. That, like, people get these things because they can't handle the taste of coffee.
Yeah, I've actually eaten dirt.
There's no caffeine in it.
All right, guys. I made this guy surrender.
It depends on the frappuccino you get, because some of them have a coffee base and some of them have a cream base, and the coffee-based ones do have caffeine in them.
Yeah, and they're slightly healthier, but... The cream-based ones are the fat ones. Anyway, something else you shouldn't eat, which, duh, Cold Stone's peanut butter and chocolate shake.
I actually haven't been there in a while, so cool.
So you probably kind of already figured that, you know, milkshakes aren't the most healthiest, but this particular shake that's made with chocolate ice cream, milk, and peanut butter is a whole class of its own. This frosty monster delivers an entire day's worth of calories and almost 3.5 times the daily limit of saturated fat.
Wait a minute, I have a question. Is one of them a mooncake?
Look, if you want to know, let me get through the goddamn list. That's how you find out what's on.
No, because we got a bazillions of them.
Eat them. Tell me how fat you get.
These things are, like, so bad for you, and yet I keep eating them, and they taste like shit, so.
Yeah, those are terrible.
What, mooncakes? You've had one before?
Yeah.
They are disgusting, but I keep eating them. I don't know why.
So, anyway, this shake is 2,010 calories, 131 grams of fat. Holy shit. I mean, that's a large, but holy shit. Instead, you should get a 16-ounce Sinless O Fudge Shake. Same chocolate taste, but a quarter of the calories. So there, Chris. Sir. Next up, which normally you guys should be talking during this because it takes my computer a minute. Oh, no. Auntie Anne's Jumbo Pretzel Dog. This got me through so many airport visits.
Really?
Yeah, like...
Why are they dead? Because they're jumbo?
Probably. And because of the hot dog.
But hot dogs aren't... Are they really bad for you? Because I thought they were just meat.
Well, they're...
You know hot dogs are literally, like, the extras of, like, the pigs and everything. Like, it's not actual real meat.
If you at least get all beef, they're somewhat better. If you get the hodgepodge of whatever the fuck they grinded up together,
yeah. If you want a good... Yeah. If you want to eat a hot dog, you have to get the all beef one, or else, if not, you're just literally eating the trash from the pig.
Yeah. And whatever
else.
This
gun I'm using sucks. Accuracy is horrible. I'm never...
Hey. Talk about that when we have the guest. Sir.
And please don't rip it before they get on the show.
Right?
No, it's not actually not. It's, I mean,
the game
it's
fucking sucks.
So truth
be told, it's probably just
Jimmy's
personal skills because we all know he has none.
We hope to just yell at you about it in 2 weeks. Anyway, one of these jumbo pretzel dogs with butter have 610 calories. What?
From where?
Where the fuck were you?
I was peeing. I told you I had to pee.
Annie Ann's, Dave.
There's no peeing during
not
this
Annie
show.
Ann. I get it every time I'm in the airport.
See, that's
Why
what
would
I
do
said.
That?
That's
wow.
exactly what I said.
Breach and immediately die. That's
it
sucks.
Gets me through the airport.
Why would you do this to me?
Just don't get a jumbo pretzel dog.
Go get a jumbo pretzel dog.
I'll eat the boarding pass, because you don't fucking need those anymore. Fuck this shit. Fuck your list. Fuck Annie Ann.
Instead, with a pretzel without the butter and salt, so that'll be terrible, like eating cardboard, but it'd be healthy.
Nothing's healthy for you guys.
Okay, this one's a big duh. But Cinnabon's caramel pecan bun. That thing looks like diabetes. That is diabetes. And it's
fucking gross.
One bun is 1,092 calories, 56 grams of fat, and 47 grams of sugar.
Yeah, that's so attractive.
That was so sexy. Just saying.
If you somehow needed a Cinnabon and wanted something that's the closest to healthy you can get from that place, get a mini bun. It's smaller.
They come in four.
No, those are the bites or something. Like the middles of the bun, that's why.
Yeah, you still get like four of them, though.
Not with the mini bun. The mini bun is just, it's literally a smaller Cinnabon.
You are not the expert on buns here.
I don't just have any.
Exactly. So shut your face. They come in four. Seen it. Know it.
No, that was in the middle of the buns. Like
you're in the middle of a bun!
I don't have a bun!
You fucking turd! Calling you a turd.
Buy a DVR!
You buy a DVR!
Pay for it!
Are you guys done?
No. Well, yeah, probably. For now.
Alright.
Oh my god. What the hell happened in that battle?
Next up is Wendy's sweet and spicy boneless wings.
Are you sure?
Yes. This meal isn't that bad if it's your entire lunch, but it has more salt than you should have in a day.
Really?
Let alone in one sitting.
I question that.
One order has 550 calories, 18 grams of fat, 27 grams of sugar, and 2,530 milligrams of sodium. Mm-hmm. Holy sodium. That's a heart attack. Instead, get the ultimate chicken grill. It's a grilled chicken breast on a sesame seed bun that's only 320 calories, 7 grams of fat, 8 grams of sugar. Still has 950 milligrams of sodium, but if as long as you don't do it daily, you'll be okay.
Sodium.
Sorry. You got it.
Then again,
I'm
not a doctor, so.
Gotta do it daily, my friend.
He knows everything.
Next up is Dunkin' Donuts Coffee Cake Muffin.
I don't eat that shit. Coffee.
Muffins are often mistaken for the donut's healthy cousin.
Is it me, or does it seem like majority of these things are coffee places?
Most of them have been.
A lot of bread type items.
Interesting.
I would say he's ruining everything in an airport.
What it's coming down to be is don't get anything from a coffee place. Okay. Or an airport. Okay.
He has ruined every airport stop I have ever seen.
So, instead of getting the coffee cake muffin, just get yourself one glazed donut. 220 calories, 9 grams of fat. You'll be all right.
Who makes the
son.
All right, here's one that's not from a coffee shop airport thing. This is from the good hometown's stop of Olive Garden. I don't know where I was going with that introduction.
Yeah,
Olive Garden. Yeah, it's when you're there, you're family.
Tour of Italy. Don't you dare say Tour of Italy.
Olive Garden. Grilled shrimp caprese? I'm not Italian.
No, how is grilled no shrimp? It's grilled, for crying out loud. If it's fried, okay.
Shrimp are low-fat, low-cal, and high in protein and iron. What's not to like? But, in fact, the garlic butter sauce in this dish helps rack up nearly two-thirds of your daily fat. Now, does that mean, like, you lick the plate afterwards?
Ew!
Sorry, I got a fact that sounds disgusting.
But you know what I mean? Like, anyway, whatever. 900 calories, 41 grams of fat, 3,490 milligrams of sodium. So if you're out there and you want a healthier meal at Olive Garden, get a lighter version of this dish without the melted cheese and with marinara sauce on the side. Or the Venetian apricot chicken is another option.
No. Why would you want to do that? That
but
disgusting.
You're going to fatten yourself up with all the breadsticks you're going to eat anyway. I mean,
yeah, you ain't kidding. Oh, God.
Of Italy. So I just got, like, from one of our listeners, the food police have apparently found that 90% of McDonald's within our country are trying to use human meat as a filler. And 65% use horse meat.
Where are they getting the human meat?
Yeah, really?
Can I sign up to be a Big Mac?
I'll be a Big Mac. Fuck that.
Yeah, I don't want to be an organ donor anymore. I want to be in people's food.
I don't.
I'm inside you.
It does give a whole new meaning to eat me.
It does.
Like a third
me,
meaning. Like the second one. If a girl's saying it, we know what they mean. If a guy's saying it, it's kind of like, oh, that's like...
He could
I
be
don't
mean,
even
like,
think Trish knows what that means.
He could mean toss my salad or something. You know?
Side note, you know how they keep saying that the whole, like, oh, I want to eat your ass like groceries? I feel like they're setting themselves up to be victims of the human centipede. Like, they're already pre-gaming. That's pre-gaming
that
the human centipede.
True. It could be. You never know.
I feel like it is.
So do you think,
eat your ass like groceries. That's
so they'd be okay.
But the ability to pull away.
That would be okay, then, for them to be part of the human centipede. Like, they'd be like, oh, this ain't so bad.
It's consent. If you're going to sit there and say, I'm going to eat your ass like groceries, you're literally saying, yes, please sew my mouth through someone's asshole. All
right.
Right?
All right, I agree.
These are the things I think about
that.
Before I go to sleep.
Chili's onion string and crispy jalapeno stack.
That's terrible.
Duh, but duh. The unhealthy behemoth that was removed from the menu... But its replacement is only a bit better. This appetizer is meant to be shared. But even one quarter of the dish delivers an entire day's limit of fat.
Yeah, fat.
I don't know. 2,130 calories, 213 grams of fat, because everything is fried with friedness over fried. Not that chili is exactly healthy as far as appetizers go, but you could just do chili.
Sorry, I was going to go into something very offensive to Mexicans, and then stop.
Chili, baby back ribs.
Barbecue sauce.
Sorry. Macaroni grills kids? Fettuccine.
Oh, my God.
I know
kids' meals, in theory, are smaller than adult portions because children simply don't need as many calories. The average 10 to 12-year-old... The upper age limit for many kids' menus need about 1,600 to 1,800 calories daily. This meal puts them at half of that.
I've never eaten
the more with more fat than a grown adult needs in a day. One of these fettuccines has 809 calories, 67 grams of fat. Instead, coax your little one into getting the grilled chicken and broccoli. They're not going to eat the broccoli, but at least they'll eat the chicken.
Get the hell out of here.
Does that specifically say that, or did you say that? Because it's pretty funny.
I added that in.
It's pretty funny. I like it.
Because I really don't think... Broccoli, you're not going to win the argument with that. Like, you're going to love broccoli, Timmy. It's healthy.
It's green. It's like eating a tree. Imagine you're a giant. Holy shit.
Is Quiznos still a thing?
No. According to John Oliver, they're fading it out.
Okay, well, if you find a Quiznos out there somewhere, somehow, don't get the chicken with honey mustard flatbread salad.
Gibby.
Why?
Because unhealthy salads lurk everywhere. They promise grilled chicken, leafy greens, and fewer carbs.
Dace, we're going to have to end the show because I really need you to go watch this.
But often deliver bacon, cheddar cheese, and high-fat dressing. Don't be tricked.
Really?
This salad will cost you half your day's calories. The dressing alone has 48 grams of fat. Nearly
Jesus
daily.
Christ.
One salad, dressing and bread included, has 1,070 calories, 71 grams of fat, and 1,700 milligrams of sodium. Instead, get the Cantina Chicken Sammy. It's small, but it's 205 calorie, low fat, veggie filled flatbread sandwich.
Really nice. Really,
this is where you
really talk to him in his segment.
This is your chance to talk for a minute. See, I pause, you guys get to talk, and then it's back on me. Pizza Hut
Pizza
Zone. Yes.
No!
For this 1 pound monster, feature hungry dudes who don't want to share. One child now tells another who looks on longingly to order his own. But these pizza crust calzones should be shared, preferably with a crowd. Eating the whole thing is akin to consuming about 6 cheese slices in one sitting.
Been eating pizza calzones for months. Why?
And it delivers 1.5 times your daily limit for sodium. Your heart's going to explode. One serving size is 1/2 of a pizzone. The whole pizzone is 1,480 calories.
Down
66 grams of fat and 3,680 milligrams of sodium. So the disgusting choice you can get if you want to try to be healthy from Pizza Hut is pull a bullet in your head. Or get one slice of the natural veggies lover multigram pizza.
Next waypoint, guys.
Like, really?
I'm
who the fuck's gonna
eat? Oh, I'm gonna kill that dog too. Oh, it's not fair. Oh, fat because of pizza.
Oh, this one's a little heartbreaking too.
No, heartbreaking. I'm gonna die. Don't do it.
Lunchables, new wholesome deep dish pepperoni fun pack.
No, not Lunchables.
I eat the ham.
Ideally, a lunchbox should strike a balance between taste, fun, and nutrition. I don't know who has fun eating lunch. Like
I do. I love eating lunch.
However, an easily prepackaged solution like Lunchables may not deliver.
Me.
The nutrition info is based on a 2,000 calorie a day diet. That's of a grown adult. Processed food is too high in fat and sodium for the average 8-year-old's daily recommended intake.
Well, Lunchables are made for 90.
So really, it's okay if you're an adult eating these. It's just don't give them to your kids.
Good news is I'm an adult eating them. Yay!
Because it has 420 calories, and yeah.
I had like 3 on the way back from my indie drive, because there was like 3 meals in there.
I feel like this is just picking on Ruffles. Ruffles cheddar and sour cream flavored potato chips.
No!
They make the garlic cheesy bread ones, too.
Why are they picking on the cheddar and sour cream chips? Like, are they really worse than the other flavor chips?
Yes, they are.
They probably have a lot of sodium.
Yeah.
Ruffles don't just have ridges. They also have 17% of the upper limit of daily fat in just one serving. The calorie count is low, but chances you'll eat more than a serving, as most packages are larger, 1.5 ounce size. The 1 ounce serving is 160 calories, 11 grams of fat, and 230 milligrams of sodium, but odds are you're going to eat the whole bag. That's 240 calories, 16.5 grams of fat, and 345 milligrams of sodium.
They're healthier than those cheese puff things.
So instead, if you really don't have taste buds, try the baked Ruffles original flavor. 120
if you
calories.
Love anal leakage, that's your chip.
Right?
Yeah, baby. Gotta love that anal leakage.
Diarrhea.
All right, next up on the list is Häagen-Dazs Dulce de Leche low-fat
no
frozen
shit.
Yogurt.
No shit. Häagen-Dazs.
Low-fat frozen yogurt. Frozen yogurt is often relatively healthy. Even the most decadent flavors tend to have less fat than ice cream. However, not all froyo is created equal. To be fair, this flavor does have 15 grams less fat than regular ice cream flavor, but serving packs 25 grams of sugar. One half cup of this bad stuff is 190 calories, 2.5 grams of fat, 25 grams of sugar, and 35 grams of carbs.
In your face.
What you should try instead is try a brand that offers a no-sugar added option, such as Eddie's, the French vanilla flavor, has only 100 calories, 3 grams of fat, and 14 grams of carbs, and only 4 grams of sugar. So your teeth will shine and be pretty.
Eddie's.
So pretty much you've gone through this list and ruined everything that I like.
That's what
it's
I'm here for.
Vagina, because, you know, just, you know, take away everything.
Yeah, I might as well just take that away from him as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Vagina. You can't have vagina anymore because it makes you fat.
Here's something you don't eat, so it's not going to ruin your day.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Cars yogurt apple nut mix.
Yeah, that's
works
true.
Like yogurt, apple, and
what
nuts.
What the hell?
Making snacks seem healthy. But a certain size is 1 ounce. The tiny snack often found in vending machines contains nearly three times as much, 2.75 ounces. Bags in stores contain five times as much. What? I totally read that wrong. Anyway, eating the whole 2.75 ounce bag, and you've consumed 412 calories. That's the equivalent of half a snack bar. Snickers bar,
yeah,
not a snack bar.
Keep the nuts out of your mouth.
1 ounce serving, 150 calories.
Get it out of your mouth.
Instead, you should have a healthier trail mix, like peeled snacks, a 2/3 cup serving of fruit and nuts, figs. What? What is that?
Keep the nuts out of your mouth. How do you motherfucker?
I really bet that's probably not all that bad for you. They're just picking on people now.
Yeah. Say, how do you mother for me?
Hi, Mom. Arnold's, why are they picking on Arnold's? Why is their bread so much worse than everybody else's bread?
What the hell?
Anyway, Arnold's whole grain country white bread. Don't
sounds
fall
like
for the whole grain marketing trick without knowing all the facts. While whole grain, air quotes, sounds good, this product doesn't have nearly the amount of heart-healthy whole grains as products that say 100% whole grain. In other words, they use like two whole grains, not all of them. Two slices is 220 calories, 4 grams of fat, 420 milligrams of sodium, 42 grams of carbs, and 4 grams of fiber. Helps you poop.
Instead,
try two slices
like
of Lifeline of bread.
It is.
Like 100% whole wheat, 80 calories.
Let me know what you're doing. You're going to guy, I guess.
I
am.
There's
a loser in the back room.
That's because I have a feeling if I don't stop talking, then you guys don't interrupt.
Don't
or I just keep going and don't pay attention that you're talking. So, yeah, bread is not healthy for you, is really what it's saying.
Bread
unless
is
you get, like, 100%
healthy.
Whole grain. Oh. I don't know.
How am I getting shot at, guys?
Well, Dace eats healthy cereal, so I don't think this is going to knock him down.
I like Raisin Bran.
Yeah, see, you're old. But
old.
Reese's Puffs cereal.
Oh.
Starting your morning off with this bowl of sugary puffs may be worse than getting up on the wrong side of the bed.
Especially if there's a wall there.
One serving of this breakfast treat has more sugar than an actual Reese's peanut butter cup.
And the male semen.
A 3/4 cup serving with half
get
a cup of
skim
milk is 160 calories, 3 grams of fat, 12 grams of sugar. The Reese's cup only has 7 grams of sugar. Go figure.
I don't know what in the world you're talking about.
Choose instead for organic and natural, probably disgusting take on the peanut butter puff. Check out Enviro Kids Peanut Butter Panda Puffs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes your kids grow up to be pussies.
Yep. Panda Puffs. That's what you're going to get of your kid. Panda Puffs.
Let them go to school and say they eat Panda Puffs. Watch them come home with black eyes.
Brian, Zoidberg says the show needs to end because she has to pack and sleep.
Hey, Zoidberg, shut the fuck
anything.
Up. You're going to sleep on the car ride and don't lie.
She will. I won't.
Tits, you can just log off now. You're bringing nothing to the table but interrupting me with stupid things.
I completely agree
zing
with that one.
Zing! In your tight vagina. Zing!
What? What are you doing to her what?
I didn't do anything to her vagina. I'm just saying
you
zing.
Just said you were doing something to it.
Well, how'd you know it was tight? I'm just curious.
Right? You kind of had some facts in there that you're just throwing around.
Yeah.
I think our general theme every week has been who's going to fuck that.
She could have a dildo. That
you guys
or Danny
DeVito. I think Danny
time.
DeVito would. I
Danny
think Danny
DeVito
would prefer.
Really? Interesting. I mean,
gotta
if you think so, that's fine.
To the boys' home.
I really feel like there's probably worse Pop-Tart flavors than this, but Kellogg's Pop-Tarts, brown sugar, and cinnamon.
Brown sugar!
At least breakfast cereals have relatively easy-to-understand serving sizes. Pop-Tarts, on the other hand, report nutrition information for one serving, but each package contains two, and it's impossible to reseal. Then you get a Ziploc bag. Like, don't
that's
admit defeat.
Funny.
Just, oh, no, I've opened it. I have to eat both. Woe is me. I can't store this Pop-Tart any other way. But eat both, and this breakfast delivers a quarter of your daily limit for fat and more than half your added sugar for the day.
What does that
instead,
mean to me?
What?
What does that mean to me?
It means you should eat instead just one pastry, or you can try Fiber One's brown sugar cinnamon toaster pastry.
Fiber One!
They suck.
The stuff that makes
they
you
suck.
Go...
Yep, help you poop real good. Next up is Power Bars Performance Energy Cookies and Cream.
Okay,
power bars
no,
are often shaped like candy bars and can taste like them too, but the thing about power bars is they're practically meal bars. It doesn't actually
what
say that often, but come on.
Those as snacks?
This particular power bar has 1 gram of fiber, so it's not going to help you poop, but nearly 3/4 of the upper limit of daily added sugar. So
everybody does. Who doesn't eat them? That's my question.
If you really want a power bar, well, if you wanted to, try the Power Bar Harvest line made with whole grains. One oatmeal raisin cookie bar still has 250 calories, 40 grams of carbs, but it offers 10 grams of protein.
If I ate a power bar a day, I'd be 300 pounds by the end of the week. Easily.
Well, not it.
Is that good or bad?
It's bad. Well, unless I want to be a 300-pound sumo wrestler.
You might be jacked.
Well, I'm just asking. I mean, you're not, you know.
Go on.
Go
on. Thank you, buddy, so I can shoot you down.
Healthy choice, sweet and sour chicken.
You're fat, too. You can't use that excuse when you're
is better than a TV dinner.
I bet you I'm skinnier than you.
Options from this generally trustworthy brand. The calories are reasonable, but the meal is high in sugar and sodium, and it has more fat than most other healthy choice options. Even the chicken fettuccine Alfredo and the country breaded chicken. One meal is 400 calories, 13 grams of protein, 5 grams of fiber, but 10 grams of fat, 20 grams of sugar, and 500 milligrams of sodium. Instead, get the oven roasted chicken meal. It's about half of everything because I don't feel like reading all that again. Next up is vitamin water. Yeah, vitamin water uses the old trick in the book, which is the nutrition information on the label is based on a serving size, but the bottle contains multiple servings, leaving you to do the math. Each bottle contains 2.5 servings of the sugar-sweetened water. So a whole bottle delivers 33 grams of sugar. A can of Coke only has 6 more. And that's a lot of calories when plain water could just do the trick.
Yeah.
One bottle, 2.5 servings. Of the charge flavor, that's a flavor charge, 125 calories and 32.5 grams of sugar.
Yeah.
The new Vitamin Water 10 has only 10 calories, but it contains 0 calories sugar sweeteners, which probably gives you cancer.
Yeah.
Cancer.
Yeah, baby, yeah.
50 Cent gives you cancer. You heard it here first.
What?
I told that Loch Ness Monster, damn Loch Ness Monster, I don't got no tree for that. Loch Ness Monster, you know what you need no tree for that? I'm like, I'm not going to give you no tree for that Loch Ness Monster.
Sorry.
You heard it here first. 50 Cent gives you cancer.
He does.
Sure, he'll appreciate that accusation.
I tweeted it. It's real.
Stop tweeting things with my name.
It's not your name. It's the show's name.
They're going to be like, hey, we were going to give you this job, but remember this
god-awful show you were on before where you were just crude and rude and, like, that's why I'm applying to Sirius.
Yeah, we've said a lot worse things on the show.
You all did. I haven't.
Have I? I probably have. That's probably a
lot. No, you've been a god or something, goddess. You've been a sweet, lovable angel. Anyway, Quaker Natural Granola Low Fat. Granola is tricky. Although the name is practically synonymous with healthy, some types, including this cereal, contain a startling amount of sugar, so that way it tastes yummy.
Uh-huh.
One serving contains 18 grams of sugar. That's as much as a Twinkie.
Twinkie! I need a Twinkie!
So instead, you should have Health Valley's low-fat, date, almond flavor.
He's fat!
Rude.
He's fat! He's fat!
Rude.
John Cena! Ear rape.
That was unnecessary.
It probably. I agree.
I think no. Maybe this isn't. I think I have one more or two more after this. It's near the end of the slideshow. But it's where it only said 25, and this
feels
is
like
24.
80.
I was gonna say this is like really high, dude.
Well, I'm sorry for bringing something to the table.
Yeah. Okay.
I bring something to the table.
Bare Naked Chocolatey Cherry Granola Bar. We love Bare Naked for its generally low-fat, low-sugar concoctions, but we just can't get behind this bar.
Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-red.
It almost has the same nutritional stats as a Hershey's sweet and salty Reese's peanut butter bar. Or you could eat almost three Nature Valley oats and honey granola bars for the same intake. One 54-gram bar has 230 calories. Instead, you should get Barbera's Crunch Organic Oats
buggy.
And Honey Granola Bar.
Oh, my God.
Two bars have 190 calories.
Is Barbera the best?
The best.
Boy,
boy,
I don't guess.
Boy, I don't guess.
Shameless plug. Amy's Organic Thai Coconut Soup. I don't know what the hell this is or where they found it. But generally, we love anything from this vegetarian brand. Who's heard of this brand? But we draw the line at this soup. While packed with veggies and protein powerhouse tofu, one serving has more than half your daily limit of saturated fat. So instead, go get Amy's low-sodium vegetable soup.
Basketball Jones!
And last but not least...
You got a Basketball Jones!
Never mind, that was the last one. It just says, it titled this slide the last slide and just kind of said the end. So there you go. Don't go out there and eat those things that I mentioned.
Oh, I love John Cena bombing
people.
If you want
to get fat, do it.
Yeah.
Ooh, something felt good. It's
so,
me.
My turn?
Done. I'm done.
Jesus.
All right, Mr. DeMille, I'm ready for my close-up.
Good job.
Fight my shiny metal ass.
Yeah, bitch!
And here we go.
Time for celebrity news. Something that has probably not been on this show for the 2 weeks that I've been out because all my co-hosts slack when it comes to this part.
No, I did it last week.
Fuck you.
I highly doubt it.
Damn thing.
I highly doubt it.
Damn thing.
I blatantly skip this segment if I'm hosting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She made me do celebrity news last time.
No, we made you do. We made you do everything last.
Yeah,
time.
Yeah, it was the Gibby show with us just heckling him on.
Tell ya.
Well, that's because me and Frank couldn't get we had really shitty connection issues last week.
Sure.
Oh, I know. I heard it when I was editing.
Yeah, it was awful.
It was the best show ever.
I don't know what happened. I really have no clue.
It was your best performance, yeah.
It was.
Break it down.
Make it into a remix. Hoo-ah!
Anyway,
celeb
news.
Naomi Scott has been cast as the Pink Ranger in the upcoming Power Rangers reboot.
Who is she?
She's in The Martian, and she's also was in the TV drama Terra Nova that only lasted a year. She's pretty hot.
Did you know she's going to be the Pink Ranger?
Yes. Rumor has
I thought I'd bring it up. Just thought I'd help
for
you
for those nerds out there, including the one that's on the show, Star Wars Battlefront released the beta edition for tomorrow.
That's what Dan's been doing.
Yep, goodbye, Dan Ralph.
Oh, that's what she's from.
Oh, God.
No.
Late to the game.
Dan?
Late to the game.
Oh, fuck Dan. I don't give a shit about him.
Hey, what?
Yeah, buddy.
Hey, what?
Brown chicken, brown cow.
A new trailer was released today also by Benedict Cumberbatch for the upcoming season of Sherlock.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
Special.
Cumberbitch.
Also, the Rocky Horror Picture Show celebrates its 40th anniversary. Other celebrity news, Justin Bieber. The photos appear to show singer lounging while nude on balcony in Bora Bora. For all our female listeners out there, that we're going to like to see it. Ba-bam.
Bora Bora.
What else is there going on? There was some stuff. New York Comic Con's tomorrow.
Woo!
Woo!
Fucking Gibby's not going.
Woo! Oh.
Did he just woohoo?
I wooed.
No,
I
Frank
think he did. Left.
I wooed.
Shame.
He probably had to get another beer.
Wait a minute. Didn't you just make fun of Dan Ralph for doing the Battlefront beta?
Yeah.
10 minutes ago, he posted a status saying, anyone else going to play the Battlefront beta on PC?
He is obsessed with that game, and that's why NASA's trying to wipe him out. If you had listened to our story earlier, he is a threat to America.
Dan Ralph.
I know you were all worried about me, but I'm back.
No, we weren't worried. We were actually happy.
Sure you didn't. Thanks for not worrying, guys.
Oh, is that where? Was that a hint for me to click something? Was I supposed to? Was I supposed
John
to...
John Cena!
No. Not... I don't know where it is, actually.
What's with all these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane?
In other news, Daniel Craig has officially said he is dumb.
Sorry, I was late.
With his Bond movie and wants to leave them in, quote, a good place. So Daniel Craig is out as Bond. Who will be the next Bond? I think it should be Gibby.
I heard the rumors were Tom Hardy.
Jason Statham.
I'd like a martini. Shake it, not stirred.
Jason Statham for president. I mean,
Trish
Bond.
Honestly,
Trish Dad for president. I mean, Bond.
Attracted the darkness, molded by the darkness to become the Bond. I have broken the bat.
Ow!
Yes! Win! Win!
Great
win!
Thing ever. You're hearing it here first, folks. Tits is dying. You're welcome.
Thank
you.
God.
Got your
the dog was biting me.
Good dog.
Good dog. Good dog. Good dog.
Good dog. Who's a good dog?
Very good dog. Very good doggy.
Who's a good doggy? Doggy.
A dog deserves a bone.
That's what she's biting me for.
Kevin Corcoran, producer and actor
her bone away from her.
Old Yeller, died at 66. And Meryl Streep, the actress who could do no wrong, is facing backlash following the Suffergate T-shirt.
Hell yeah, retweet that curling stuff. Boom.
I thought she died.
So there you have it, folks. That's your celebrity news, a segment that only takes 10 minutes rather than half hours.
You're welcome.
Gibby's takes 45 minutes.
You're welcome for bringing substance to this show.
Substance or was just heartbreaking disaster because...
Same difference.
Now I can't eat half that shit. Like, what am I fucking supposed to drink this weekend, Frank?
Your mom.
Nos.
Chicken.
Pussy.
Can't eat chicken.
Dick.
Pussy. Maybe.
Asshole.
Not dick. Asshole, human centipede. So
water.
No.
Can do water. Water's not a bad choice.
Ew! Ew!
Water.
Ew!
Gatorade.
Gatorade.
I'm imagining you all want to get off the show. Gibby, what do you got going on?
Yeah, we're 23
show.
Minutes
I got
overdue.
Nothing better to do.
I got to jerk off and take a shower.
So, yeah,
wait,
how about
Peg,
them
are
cowboys?
Are you going to Walmart?
No.
Are you going to Walmart?
Why are you going to Walmart?
I was going to go get some food and shit to eat for when we're at the convention.
Oh.
She's trying to be proactive. I don't like it.
Because I'm not paying $6 for a churro that's so fucking hard I could play baseball with it.
I don't like her. She's being way too proactive.
Sounded kind of racist.
I'm rich as fuck, so I don't care.
She is a whore, so...
No, you're not. You just bought a new car.
Because I'm rich as fuck.
Bitch.
I have faith in...
Bitch.
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 Just because you don't have money doesn't mean we don't have money.
About?
Just saying.
We have to bring you on the show to keep the demographic equal. Like, if
exactly.
We just pander to rich people... None of the poor people would listen to us.
I thought I was on here because you guys needed a female.
You covered
two
demographics.
No, Dace is transgender now.
Yeah,
Dace is
know.
Transgender.
It happened before the show went on the air.
Sorry. Yeah, you did. Everyone heard it.
Rocky good.
That was in the group.
Yep.
It was great.
But you were,
when
we didn't think
you
were capable of transgender.
I was a regular Frankie fan.
He's being so brave being on a podcast and being called a transgender.
Yep. Give me a night show, please. Please. I am a trans...
Right?
Probably
equal rights. Equal rights.
Equal
rights.
Equal
rights. Right.
Equal rights.
Equal
rights.
Equal
rights. Equal. It was great when it all began. I was a regular freaking fan.
So everyone now has to call him Christina.
No, we can still call him Chris. And I'm keeping the dick. Really, the only thing woman about me is when I like to sing. So I'm like
and
Cher.
And your hair.
I'm the opposite of Cher. Cher
and
likes to sing as a man.
And your beautiful
but
eyes. And your boobs.
I do have nice boobs. They're kind of hairy. I guess I could shave them for breast cancer awareness.
Wax is probably better.
Oh. Fuck wants to do that?
Nobody.
It was
welcome
great
to be
when
a girl.
Wait. Tits, you wax your tits?
No.
You
but
do?
For him, he'd need to wax them. My boobs are nice and hairless.
The facts come out now, guys. The facts come out now.
Pics or didn't happen.
Pics are exactly.
No.
Where are the pics?
You're never going to get a picture of my boobs, ever.
And you have a hairy chest. You are disgusting.
You are disgusting.
Okay.
Jeez.
Are we still on the show?
I don't know.
We have a couple listeners.
We do? Hello!
Hello, listener number one. Hello, listener number two. Hello, listener number... Oh, we still have more, too.
As we say hello, we say goodbye!
Is that fair?
I have the fact that I am apparently going
hello.
To do an interview with
hello.
Something for some reason, for some person, for a reason I wasn't informed of.
Okay.
So you can email me or Dance Man Show, or you could do nothing.
What?
So,
or dance. Like
there was a request. By one of our listeners,
we have a request.
To wax me live on air.
Yes!
Frank Klein, are you listening again?
No, this wasn't Frank.
Next week, we wax Chris Dace live on air. Spread him out on the bar table.
They won't even be able to see him, though.
Oh,
spread
him
out on the bar. Spread him out on the bar downstairs. Let Gibby
who
and I go to town
that?
On waxing him.
Huh.
Don't want to be
is this
waxed.
A woman?
It was a woman who suggested it.
Who? Your mother?
It's called Nunya. Her name's Nunya. She's from the Asian
Nunya.
Descent of Nunya business.
Nunya.
Oh, no, he Nunya. Didn't. Burn! Burn! Frank, what do you got going on?
I'm surprised. Whoa. I have this one thing where I'm going to be at Comic-Con tomorrow through Sunday. So,
no, you're not. No, you're
come
not.
By. We'll be wearing our Dace Man Show hoodies. All right, I will
no,
be,
you're not.
I guess. I don't know
you're
what...
Not.
I don't know about the guy that claims, you know, it's his name and his show and yells at me for tweeting things.
Because for 3 years I've been playing a character, and I want people to know that the character that is on this show is not the real Chris Dace.
Yes, it is.
Hashtag
yes,
Julie
it is. It
no,
definitely
it's not.
Is.
It's not. The real Chris Dace is a professional businessman who makes
shit.
The
biggest
Dace.
Hunk of shit I've ever heard in my
yeah,
life.
You
no,
okay.
No, that is such
these
a hunk
characters
of shit,
are
Dace
payers, and in
minute.
Real life, they grovel at my feet.
No, Dave,
grovel
that's
at your
such
feet.
A hunk
okay,
of shit. Any of the podcasts that they've watched us doing things live, they would know that you're the same then as you are. Always.
Oh, sweet savior.
They
Dave
all know
man.
You're a loser, Dace. I'm sorry.
You don't understand. There's like 15 minutes before the show where I get pumped and I'm talking normal. Like, guys, this is what we got to do tonight. We got to boost ratings. We got to make
yeah.
money.
It was very official.
Literally...
Very official what he laid down before this show. I mean, it was ridiculous.
The moment
the show.
Theme song ends, I'm this oddball. And when the outro hits, I'm back to being normal. Just saying.
Yep, back to business.
This is a character.
No, he's not. No, he's
and
not.
None of this is real.
Lying piece of crap.
There's this crazy
this
guy.
Real.
There's this crazy Man. Guy that looks a lot
word
like
shit.
Him.
The bullshit
you wouldn't
I'm
say
hearing
the word
right
shit,
now is crazy.
So many other things. You just said crap.
The bullshit I'm hearing is crazy.
There is this crazy
Man,
guy around who just goes around.
It is stinking.
I don't know what you're talking about because... I'm very quiet, and I don't like to randomly outburst, okay?
I think
I don't know what you're talking about.
Here, guys.
I don't,
the neighbors do.
The neighbors are liars! They don't know shit!
They know more than they let on.
I'm a lovely neighbor, and I don't disrupt the peace at all. Or have any felonies. I'm just saying, that's a good thing. Trish, what do you got going on?
Yeah, Trish, what do you got going on?
Again, I'll probably be one of the idiots at Comic-Con tomorrow. I will be doing the costume contest, like I was saying. I'm pretty sure me and Dace agree that we're probably going to bring the winner on for an interview, just because, hey, we don't have anything else going on anymore.
Get out of here. I don't like her anymore. Kick her off the show.
Anyways, but yes, we will be having the costume contest. We will be giving
Can
out
we put
a
that on the website?
It's going to be on Fanboys. Not because, well, since you never made our fucking website...
There's a website.
So what are you trying to dress up as? I'm just curious.
I don't have a... I'm not dressing up. I don't have a wig for my costume yet.
She's going to be a slut.
So then what do you... What? So why you... What?
Cosplay costume contest for people at Comic-Con this weekend, you goober.
So you're just going to pick random people like you? Come here, come
no,
here. You
I
let,
have
you look good.
A plan.
Come here.
I have a plan. Relax.
You're
going to
tell
going...
everybody or no?
Are you going to
no,
tell anybody? That's what I asked. I asked you, what are you going to be? And you're not even going to tell. All right, whatever.
All right, anyways, but there Frickin will be listener. Prize. There, we're probably going to give out a prize to...
That you have no idea how to win.
Yeah, sorry.
Right
we
now,
don't
want
to go there.
Like,
shut up,
okay.
I should
sorry.
Be doing it.
Sorry, way too much work.
What are you doing?
Mm.
Anyways.
No.
We do the costume contest. There will be prizes. There are a prize given out, so... Maybe if these fuckers would shut up for once, I could explain it.
Go
nope.
On.
We're waiting.
Why don't touch the keyboard.
Play the Tip
and that's a start the show theme. Are we starting again? We only have 30 minutes left.
Woohoo!
All right. Fuck it.
Anyways, in like a week or two,
JK,
go
ahead, get your plug.
No,
I was going to say, anyways, in a week or two, check fanboysanonymous.com. That's what I'm going to put the voting up. If you do vote in the contest, one random person will be entered to win a prize, which me and Dace are still discussing. We've probably figured it out, but we're not sure yet. But, anyways...
What is she talking about?
Are you just
going to
creep on people and take pictures and then later call them up and be like, hey?
Hey, you what? Do you want to come in for an interview, guys?
It's okay when a girl does it.
Listen,
we put these pictures of you up on the internet, and you won.
We didn't shoot. We didn't even ask you if we could, but we just did anyway because
I
you looked
planned.
Good.
I don't need to elaborate for you guys. Relax.
No, you should elaborate for the
good.
Listeners.
The listeners, why do they care how I pick who gets put in the contest?
Because
if they
want to
participate.
Yeah, exactly. What is wrong with you?
They'll find out when I'm there.
All right, for the few, the
for
proud,
the
spectacular, goodbye.
I haven't been here for 2 weeks. I need to say something.
Yeah.
Don't.
He needs to say how small.
For the few, for the proud.
For the day-spectacular.
Check out alltimewrestling.net. Those guys are kicking ass down there. Sorry
no,
I haven't
don't.
Been there.
They suck.
Kicking ass.
They suck.
Fanboysnots.com. Like these guys have said, we will be at New York Comic Con tomorrow. I will be there actually working some press panels, not taking pictures of people randomly.
I'm doing panels too. Fuck off.
I'm just.
I'll be trying to cop some
feel. To those guys and jerk off, but it's okay.
I'll be dancing.
Check out our show, October 28th. Gibby's playing the game. We're gonna sit down with the creators, the guys that have brought you Halo, SOCOM, and a bunch of other good names out there. Bring us a new game called Epson. Did I say that right?
I Epson. Guess.
Epson is
That's
a printer.
It's like Epson or something. Alpha-Sia? Yeah.
We'll learn how to say the game.
It's a great game, according to Gibby.
It's actually
He's
quite interesting.
It all night
oh,
long.
He's been playing it rather than fucking podcasting. So obviously it's a good game. Those guys will be on the show October 28th here live on MegaPowersRadio.com. We're hoping to score some more interviews. And, of course, before you fucking know it, Drunk Day 3 will be here.
Yes!
Which is everybody's favorite thing. And then we'll be rolling into the Dace Tacular Gaming for our cause. Oh, Jesus, I can't believe how close these things are getting. What happened in 2015? So, for the few.
For the proud.
For the proud.
For the Dace Tacular.
Dace Tacular.
For my penis.
Wow, I don't want to end that note. It's a really small note to end on. Like, I pushed the button. Not you pushed the button. I pushed the button. I have been gone for 2 weeks.
Wow.
I have not been able to push the button. I pushed the button.
Okay, Dace, okay. We'll go with that.
I pushed the button.
You pushed the button, man. You pushed the button.